post-game, Michael Grady, Sarah Kustak, Frank Isola, game one in the books, and the Nets get the victory, 115-107. Immediate reaction right now. Kus, I'll start with you. What's your thoughts on this game?
Hey, let's talk about some resiliency out of the gates,
yep.
Losing James Harden and the way this team came together. Kevin Durant and Kyrie Irving immediately were making big buckets, but this was a complete team effort. There was a balance of beautiful basketball, a lot of grit, game-winning plays that you saw, whether it was getting on the floor, blocks, rebounding, taking care of the basketball, an excellent amount of cutting, and just offensively, the way in which we saw the chemistry take place of all of these players come together, it was just really a beautiful thing to watch.
Yeah, how are the Nets going to handle adversity? Well, we got a chance to see it 43 seconds into the game. James Harden goes out, and to think, now you expect Kevin Durant and Kyrie Irving to play like this. And Kyrie Irving is playing at a level he hasn't played at since he won a championship with Cleveland. Kevin Durant is always great. But how about the performance of a guy, Mike James, who comes off the bench? You do not game plan, if you're Steve Nash, expecting Mike James to play 30 minutes. Somebody has to make up those minutes for James Harden. Mike James had 12 points. Chris Middleton had 13. I thought to think that Mike James began the year in Russia and Blake Griffin began the year in purgatory in Detroit, and the fact that they're playing big-time minutes in the fourth quarter. This was about Kyrie Irving and Kevin Durant. Make no mistake about it. But those role players, wow.
Yeah,
wow.
You can't say that enough, especially and headed into the
Bruce
game.
Bruce Brown began the season on the bench.
Good call.
No question. And Mike James, I don't know how many minutes he played in that Boston series, came into tonight not expecting to see much action, and then boom, James Harden, as you mentioned, goes out 43 seconds into the game, and Mike James plays 30 minutes, Kus. Real quick on Harden. I feel, you know, you certainly feel for Harden. You know how badly he wants this, and that leave the game 43 seconds in was really devastating for him.
It was just so hard to see. I think all of our stomachs dropped, and of course we'll still wait and anticipate until we hear more news about it. However, you know, for James Harden and how much he has meant to this team, what he has done in terms of orchestration, the multiple setbacks he's had with this hamstring injury, you don't want to speculate and jump ahead, but given the fact that this happened so immediate in a series that is so impactful, you feel for him as a player, as the individual first, but my goodness, did his teammates come together and put on quite a performance, given the fact that he was absent.
Yeah, it's going to be a major concern. In the short term, obviously, they survived. We don't know how long he's going to be out, if he's going to be out at all. And you know James Harden. Go to basketballreference.com. It's a great website. Go look at games played. He does not miss games.
No.
And he missed that stretch this season with the hamstring injury. That's legitimate. So that's going to be the concern, because James Harden just doesn't walk off the court. The guy loves to play basketball. So that is going to be a concern. I still believe, and to Sarah's point, let's not go crazy here, but I do believe if he couldn't play, they still have enough to win with. That's how good Kevin Durant and Kyrie Irving are.
Took them a little bit to kind of get their footing. First quarter was a little bit uneven. They trailed by two. Second quarter, they got rolling, but really in the third quarter was when things took a turn for the better for the Brooklyn Nets. A 24-11 run in that third quarter, Kus.